And guys, we're back with another tutorial, and this one is probably one of the most important you will ever learn for any video editing, any audio editing, any editing software ever. It's the power of keyframes, and we're about to show you how they work right now. Keyframes are used to change parameter values between two or more points in time. Using keyframes, you can create simple animations, like fades. We'll walk you through fading out this circle. First, we'll place a circle in our project. To do this, navigate to the Titles and Generators icon on the top left, then click on it. Choose Generators, then Elements. And double-click on the Shapes thumbnail to add it to the timeline. Select the clip in the timeline and position the playhead on top of it so it's visible in the viewer. Then, navigate to the inspector on the top right. If the inspector isn't showing, be sure to toggle this icon. We're going to make an adjustment to the circle's appearance. So, we'll click on this generator's icon, and we'll adjust the circle generator. Now, we want to keyframe the opacity of the circle to fade it out. So, we'll click on the video inspector icon. And right under compositing, we'll find the opacity control. We'll set our first keyframe by clicking on this diamond-shaped keyframe icon to the right. The golden color indicates that we now have a keyframe set at the current playhead position. Now, navigate back to the timeline and move your playhead forward by the amount of time you would like the animation to span. We'll have our circle fade quickly, so we'll move the playhead just a little bit. Now, we'll navigate back up to the inspector and drag the opacity value all the way down to zero. A new keyframe will automatically be set, as we could see by this super valuable golden diamond. Believe it or not, those are the only two keyframes we need for a smooth fade out, because Final Cut Pro will create all the in-between frames automatically. Now, if we play the clip, we'll see the fade animation.
Drum roll, please.
Here's a few more tips. To navigate between keyframes, simply click on the arrows next to the parameter. When you click on the arrow, it will take you to the exact frame in the timeline where the keyframe is set. This is a great way to make adjustments to your keyframes as well. Once you've navigated to the correct keyframe, you can adjust the value of the parameter. Now, since we changed the first keyframe to 0% and the second keyframe to 100%, we'll watch the circle fade into view. There are many more ways to use keyframes in Final Cut Pro, so check out the videos in the description below to learn more.
So, if you're trying to just bring the opacity down or move something across the screen, you now know how keyframes work.
Don't forget to check out Pixel Film Studios, where you can find Final Cut Pro plugins designed for beginners and professionals alike to take your projects to the next level.
Well, spread the word, mother birds, share the knowledge. Final Cut Pro has free tutorials from Pixel Film Studios. They're awesome. Subscribe, share, comment below.